goat house build day, no idea. So we'll call it a day whatever. And it's getting there, slowly but surely. We've had a bit of a to-do. One guy that was helping, which was Toon's nephew, he's gone off to work with one of Toon's brothers a long, long way away now, so we were struggling to get another guy that was good with heights, and we finally got one. But until then, me and Toon did a couple of days working on it. All the structural bits are up for the roof, the end bits are on now, and the guy and another new guy, they're coming back this afternoon to put the new roofing sheets on. These are old bits. We've just been trying to source as much of old stuff as we can that's been stockpiled over the last few years, of stuff that's been salvaged from other places and things that have been left over. And today all we've bought is 22 roofing sheets and I think about seven centerpieces. Apart from that, a couple of bags of nails, and we've just bought one more bag of cement. The other two bags we already had, the stone and sand we already had as well. So at the moment, all it's cost us so far is a little bit of labour and about 4,000 baht for the roofing materials, so we can't moan at that. But we'll give a total cost when we're done. The things that me and Toon have been doing was I said to Toon, I wasn't happy with the span of the floor woodwork. So it was spanning from here all the way to there, and I know this bamboo we got is pretty strong, but it was too far, I reckon. So we've put these extra ones in. I've just been cutting some more timbers this morning, and then the other thing I'd like to do is again, I think it's about 3.5 meters across from one post to the centre post there, and then again there. And although we only really want this to last about a year and a half, I said to Tell, I'd prefer not to go through the actual floor, so we're going to put an extra post like that, and then underneath we're going to put another supporting beam across there. So we've got this post going in here, another one going in down there, and another one that's going to be in line with there, so across there, and then the same again down that end, so another six short posts. But the timbers is costing us nothing, so we don't mind hacking it to pieces. We've chopped quite a bit down, but I suppose what we've got on the land, we've probably cut about 20%, 20-30% at the most of the stuff that's actually this sort of size. There's loads and loads that's smaller. And there's some that are actually going along the road, our eucalyptus across the road. We haven't taken any out that butt up to the road. We've got three lines of them, so we've just been taking the second and third line out every other tree. And yeah, it's going quite well. So I've just been cutting some down that are in the fruit orchard that were bending the wrong ways, and gonna drag them out this afternoon, peel the bark off, and then put them across. I'm not happy with these supporting corner bits either. One thing, they're a bit too thin, and I don't think they come out far enough, so I'm going to be beefing them up like this one along here, and have it coming out from about there down to about there. But doing that all the way around, you can see we've been putting the corner ones on higher up as well. They're going to be on every single upright. So although we haven't got giant timbers, if you put enough up and support it enough, I think it'll last all right. Yeah, it's looking good. We're very very happy with it. So it was hard going for a couple of days, but we're getting there. And then underneath, Toon's going to be doing it, making charcoal. So non-stop charcoal making. And what that'll also do is keep a little bit of smoke on the go all the time. So stop the mozzies moving in. Right, guys, everyone allowed on the table now. We haven't let them out yet today, so we've just been out to get the cement and we gave them a load of gutting, which they love. They've had a good nosh on that. We'll let them out tonight, or late afternoon rather, and then they're easy to get back in. Well, well, well. Look at that. The guys came back after lunch and they got the whole roof on and the centrepiece as well. All done. Thank goodness. Now we can really push on, just me and Toon doing the stuff that's a lot safer. I'll tell you what, those guys were fearless. I know I used to teach working at height safety and rescue for many years, but I tell you, I was a cold sweat just watching them. I was just passing up the roofing sheets to them and a few bits and bobs, but yeah, no lanyards, no harness, not tethered onto anything. If you fell from up there, that's I wouldn't say it's game over, but that's a serious break or two. Anyway, they've got it done, and no harm done. So price for that, for a day's work, putting the roof on, 400 baht for the main man and 350 baht for the other guy. So money well spent. Me and Toon did not fancy that at all. Good, good. So we've been getting the other timbers ready. We just ran out of daylight. Just been feeding the animals. So first thing tomorrow, we'll be back out here, put the last lot of supporting beams on the floor, all the corner bracing, and then we're gonna get busy putting as much bamboo on as possible till we run out, and then we'll be back up the temple pillaging the mountainside again. That's it. Right, the goats are in with their yellow light, and just gonna shut the mozzie gate. Toon's gonna come out and do a little smoke fires. All right, guys, I might as well speak to myself, mightn't I? All right, Uwe, they're not letting you up, girl. Never mind. Right, thanks for watching, and stay tuned for the next one. And we've made a start on splitting the bamboo. Jesus, what a job. This is now officially my least favourite job I've ever done on the farm. And it's bloody painful. Imagine paper cuts, but deeper and bigger and more painful. It's lethal, the stuff is. And we've still got quite a few to split. So we spent most of the yesterday splitting some. We've got about another 15 to go. We definitely haven't got in anywhere near enough bamboo. Toon shot off today to go to the hospital. So all I've been doing is making a start on doing the floor. So let's get up on the old steps and take you into the Narnia goat guest house. Of course, I'm going to do a winding staircase going into here as well, and I've got to say, it is rock steady. Gotta be, because I get disco legs when my feet go off the floor and things start to wobble. Spacing wise, you're not going to be able to get your finger in there really, anything more than that. A small goat, a kid can get their hooves stuck in there and I can break a leg. So the goats, they're quite big, what you call knuckles, ankles, elbows, that sort of thing. Their legs are actually skinny, but if their hooves don't splay, they can get in between these. So kept them quite close, but not too close that the poo will get stuck there. Of course, bamboo isn't 100% straight, so where, let's try and find a bit where I couldn't bend it anymore, they are a little bit close. This one I haven't nailed in yet, so when I'll come to do that, I'll be putting a spacer in there just to push it across, and then I'll nail it in. But really happy with with the way it's going, and we've managed to guesstimate correctly the correct length of the bamboo that we're chopping down. So all of these are one piece. The problem is the bamboo itself, Toon's mum, she came to help us split it. She said the bamboo is a little bit young, and also we should have split it the same day we cut it. So it doesn't split that great, and unfortunately a lot of it splits. Now when it splits, say if you've got one piece that splits, you end up with one whole piece and like two thirds of a piece. Let me get down here. Now Toon's mum and dad's were absolute masters of splitting bamboo. They used to make loads of things out of bamboo for selling. So we knew it wasn't us being crap, because when Toon's mum came to give us a hand, she was like, she was just as bad as us, if not worse. So that's not true, we were awful. So here's one, and it just tapers off. It doesn't matter what you do to try and keep it straight. And so this will do about halfway. Then what we'll do, let me get another one going the other way. Oh, that's mahoosive, so let's not pick that one, Lee. Okay, this one will do. So when we lay them out there, where it's got a little bit thin, we'll just put it like that. So both the far ends, I've got the fat bits, and then these will overlap in the middle. But because we've put the extra supporting beams across there, there's no giving it whatsoever. So as long as we double up the bamboo thick enough, there won't be any dramas. It is as hard as, well, I wouldn't say it's as hard as nails, because the nails go into it, but it's really, really good bamboo. Very happy with that. Even Toon's mum was impressed with it. So we're going to go back and get some more. I need to just hit some of these nails in a little bit more. At the moment, I haven't actually nailed every single one in. Toon's mum said that you don't have to, just do every other one. But I think I'd like to do all of them, just so it ties in and adds even more strength. So really, really happy with that. When we come to this sort of bit, you can see here, I like to leave the bamboo coming out quite far, because when you nail it in, it tends to split. I can't really see where I'm shooting, but there's a split there. A lot of people cut it almost to size, and then I don't know, a lot of Thai builders that I've seen don't mind if it splits all the way to the end. See here, even this one has split all the way to the end, but people don't mind that. They say it's still strong, but I prefer to leave them nice and long, which I won't be able to do here because of these corner supports here. So what I'm gonna do, which is ingenious, I'm gonna put an extra piece of timber across here, so then it can be nailed here rather than right at the end. I thought that's quite a good idea. Not bad for me. So that's it. Bamboo floor. I said to Tom, I'd quite like to spend an evening here once it's all done, or half done, and we can get a mozzie tent in here. But the mozzies are really, really bad at the moment. I've never seen anything like it, neither's Toon. Those bloody needle nose ones, I don't know what the name of them are, but they're not your standard issue mozzies. All right, settle down. So it might just have to be a picnic on here. But yeah, it's nice and cool in there, really good. So I've got some steps planned. We're gonna go put them in the middle bit here. And what I'm aiming to do is have a flat area there, maybe a step, coming out there and then down here. So, or even a little bit out to a platform and then down again. It's just an idea we picked up on one of the farms that we went to. It seems to be easier to sort out your goats that way. So when they're ready to come out, rather than trying to chase the one or two that you want and separate them, you just wait till they come to the gate. And if you've got a gate the other side, open one gate, let them through, and close the other gate, and you've got them. No running around trying to catch bloody goats half the time. So that's a good idea. I've got to get these sorts of things out. That won't end well. I knocked myself over a couple of days ago. Luckily there wasn't a nail in it. Okay, good. Happy with the progress.